Hey Church, Pastor's Corner, April 4th, 2019. This is Pastor Josh coming to you on YouTube and Facebook. Thank you so much for joining us for our weekly update at Living Waters. The grace of God. What does that word mean to you? Been studying, you know, all morning this morning, getting ready for the message on Sunday. Been thinking about the grace of God. In my own life, the grace of God is a doctrine in Scripture, and all month long at church, we're going to be celebrating the grace of God, the amazing grace of our God. And so as we take the month of April and we build up to Easter service on April 21st, we're going to be looking at the doctrine of the grace of God. And we'll be mainly looking at this doctrine in the book of Ephesians, Paul's letter to the church at Ephesus. And I just was really moved this morning as I was studying for Sunday's message that the grace of God is something that God is really rich in. You know, God is rich in grace. That's what the word says. And when he says he's rich in grace, it means that he has innumerable, inexhaustible resources to meet our needs through his grace. And the word grace in Greek means unmerited favor. It means the kindness of God. And as a sinner, I don't know how that hits you, but this morning, all morning, it has undone me. I feel absolutely undone when I consider the grace of God in my own life and the riches of God's amazing grace, that he's never running out of grace, that he's never a spiritual pauper, you know, like living paycheck to paycheck with grace. God is the inexhaustible resource of grace, and he gives it out freely to all who call upon him. And it's the way that we're saved. We're saved by grace through faith, and this is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. And Ephesians chapter 2 in verse 7, it says that in the coming ages God is going to be displaying constantly his grace to us for all eternity. And it got me thinking about two things. What a trophy of grace I am. The only reason I'm getting to heaven is because of the grace of God. And the second thought I had is the only reason you're getting to heaven is because of the grace of God. We're all trophies of God's incredible, inexhaustible grace. And so, church, I love you. I cannot wait to spend time with you this Sunday and next Sunday, and the Sunday after that for Easter, to explore the depths of the grace of God as revealed in the person and the work of Jesus Christ on the cross. The blood of Jesus is the picture of God's grace, where it meets us in our need. And so, anyway, excited to unpack the grace of God. What does the grace of God mean for you? Something to think about today. As we go into this Sunday, I just want to throw out a couple things. I want to say thank you to all of the ladies who made such a wonderful contribution to the women's retreat last week. We had an incredible experience as a church, as an engaged network, worshiping Jesus together. All of our ladies came back just singing the praises of God and his word. And so every lady that went, thank you for going. What a blessing it was to hear that God really ministered to you. So thank you so much. And I would just say, you know, as we continue to move forward into the month of April, continue to be in prayer for our church. Continue to be in prayer personally and corporately for what God is doing in our church. These are exciting days at Living Waters. These are days where we are being amazed by the grace of God. And so as we look forward to Good Friday service and Easter services, hey, invite your friends, invite family members, people that may not know about the grace of God. You might be the person that God is raising up to invite, you know, that person to come to church and hear the message of grace. And hopefully this will be a great month where we can see people coming to Christ as Savior and getting saved and being restored to who Christ is and restored to the gospel. So trusting God for a great month. We're super excited that we get to do this together. So church, we love you. We thank God for you. We will see you on Sunday, God willing, at Riverwoods Elementary School, 10 a.m. Be blessed by the gospel, and may the grace of God be rich in your life. We'll see you on Sunday.